Hello, can anybody hear me? Yes, I'm fine. So, hi, I'm going to talk today about WordPress and WordPress deployment. I'm going to introduce myself first, then I would like to ask you something, a question about the deployment. And I'm going to talk a little bit about the goals of continuous integrity and continuous delivery of the process. Obviously, the benefits and the requirements for using the DKD deployment package, and a short demo how everything is working. I'm Ivailo, originally from Sofia. I live in Frankfurt in Germany. Currently, I'm a technical team lead, so yeah, I'm standing here, my project manager, and I'm consulting her, or my manager, how we can build better sites, how we can achieve a good technical structure, and how we can accomplish all the projects in a good way. Most of the time I'm doing type 3. I started working with WordPress in 2014. Apart from that, I love working with Solr. It's search engine, and obviously DK Deploy. 2016, I founded the company's business unit for WordPress. So now we are working also with WordPress, and we're building WordPress sites. This was a quite hard step because we are type 3 agency, and I don't know, these are two words, and type 3 guys, they don't like so much WordPress, but I love both of the systems, and I think WordPress is really great, and I would like to use it more. So I'm working at the DKD internet service in Frankfurt. We're about 60 people in two offices from 15 nations over there. This is my phone. We love pizza. We every Thursday we're doing pizza by ourselves, and we have a pizza oven. It's it's a cold or hot stone specialized oven which heats up to 350 degrees, something like this. It's a really special thing. Apart from that, obviously we are doing a lot of things, a lot of technology, and after I saw this, or basically a couple of years ago, 6 years ago, we started thinking we're working with so much technology, so every technology has its own workflow, the upgrade process is there, different in every technology, and also obviously the deployment process is different for every technology, so we thought we would like to automate everything. So automating means I don't want to do it by hand. So I want to just run a command and do something. So I'm going to talk today about how we automated the deployment process at the DKD. But first of all, I would like to ask you, how do you deploy your code? How do you transfer a package, or let's say just one line of code, from server A to server B, or from your local SCM or your Git repository to the server? Maybe you can just raise your hands if somebody is using deployment with that SFTP, so I mean really by hand. Anybody? Perfect. Git and SSH, or maybe with Capistrano. Cool. WordMove or other WordPress deployment tool? Okay. Do you have custom deployment tools? And this is my favorite one, who of you? It's just working, I mean, yeah, it just works. Because the idea of building a website or product is, I'm a developer, I would like just to code, and I don't want to care to how can I transfer the code from A to B. Who of you is working with a CI/CD process currently? I mean, the continuous delivery process. So, I'll give quite a few benefits about about this one, continuous delivery benefits high quality, high code quality, because everything is automated. Because we can really do automated tests. We can test our code for things that we don't think about. We have less errors by deploying multiple times. If there are conflicts or something breaks, we get immediate identification of what is going on. And yeah, let's say we have, besides the first point, automated code quality tests, we can do also UI test or UX test in the front end, and we can do it 24/7 because everything is automated in the continuous delivery process. So the continuous delivery process looks like this. We have a developer. The developer changes anything, builds something, and commits it to our Git repository. If there are conflicts, we immediately see it, and we can do something about it. So after that, we automate the process. Is watching our Git repository every 5 minutes, let's say, and takes the code from the Git repository and deploys it on, let's say, a staging server. The Jenkins is a software which deploys everything. It's a wrapper for commands which can do this thing. In this case, this is our staging server, and in this case also, if there is some error, the developer gets immediately the feedback, there is an error, do something. After that, I would like to have, in a continuous delivery process, I would like to have a UAT, so a user acceptance test. What about my front end? Is everything still looking the same, looks the same like I concepted it? I mean, is everything okay? And we have the UAT test, and we can see everything is green. If everything is green, then we can deploy on production. So, going live. Still, basically, we have to write all the UAT tests. Maybe we missed something, and maybe there is a test which is not so good, so we couldn't cover everything. And that's why sometimes I would like to do a rollback. In a perfect world, we can do it by just clicking on one button, or just by firing a command from the command line tool. So, and that's why we developed 6 years ago DKDeploy. What is DKDeploy? It's an extension for Capistrano. Extends Capistrano by Capistrano is a remote server automation tool. Capistrano includes already a lot of tools, like a lot of commands, like just example db at default content, so you can deploy on your system a default SQL content or some database content with just one command. Another thing, you can deploy also automated your assets, let's say from one your images folder. This is your default content, you want to deploy it on your server, not via SFTP, just with a command. And Capistrano brings already a lot of things. So we built a wrapper basically for Capistrano, where we can extend Capistrano by more things. And DKDeploy extends Capistrano with a Python machine. You can easily say, yeah, I want this file to have this permission, and please check it on every deployment, because maybe some developer just connected to with SSH to the server and changed the one file, and I want to modify it every time, or that all my files are secure enough to work in the internet. More of DKDeploy, we have the rollback manager. It's quite easy, really, to make a rollback. You will see it in a live demo why this is so easy. And yeah, my favorite one on every deployment. I mean, we currently deployment takes about 2 minutes, but in some cases, in some upgrade cases, maybe you need a deployment for it takes for 10 minutes. So it's good to have a static maintenance page, so that your user knows what's going on. So as a dkdeploy brings a one-step deployment. So you can easily say cap stage, stage is the name of your stage, and deploy. Takes, package everything and deploys it on your desired stage. The benefits are, we don't have so much human interaction, so we have less steps that we can miss. So I remember 2016, my first WordPress project, I was working on the changes, I modified 20 files, and then going live, I forgot about one file, and it broke everything, basically. And here, you don't have to do it, you don't have to copy it manually to a server. You don't have a manual SSH to the server. Let's say if you want to run a migration from A to B, or as Guy mentioned in a WooCommerce talk, maybe I want to upgrade to the newest version and make the database migration, so the WooCommerce database tables are migrating from the WordPress standard tables. And one of the best things, basically, for me is that I can easily extend it by more tasks. Maybe I need to, let's say, run a ES6 converter to normal JavaScript, or maybe any Bower or NPM, something. I can just wrap it inside of dkdeploy and tell them, take this, do this, and that's it. Roll back to a previous stage. This is the command. Basically, I'm missing a cap stage name. Maybe it would be cap dev for development, or cap production for the production, and that's it. What do we need for using dkdeploy is, first of all, SSH server to SSH user to the server. So the good thing is we can work with any hoster. We need only one user, SSH user, and there is no service side installation. We can work from our computer, from our local computer, and deploy something on a hoster. Some user file permissions to the document root. Yeah, the user should be able to write and modify a couple of folders. Locally, we have to have Ruby bundler, PHP 7. Yeah, we're working on PHP 7 and Composer. Basically, that's it. And with these requirements, with this software, we can easily take the code and deploy it somewhere, and without not so many errors, let's say. The workflow is like this. I'm doing my local changes, my local adaption. I commit it to my repository, push it, and run cap dev deploy. That's it. So, I want to show it to you. So, I'm using a pre-built background box, where I already installed dkdeploy and dkdeploy PHP. In the next slide I will explain what's the difference between the different gems. So, my WordPress site. First thing I would like to do is, let's add an admin user to the backend. And that's why I cap minus T, you can filter for tasks, for jobs. And there is my WordPress. This is a custom WordPress job for adding a backend user. I will explain how this everything is working. Yeah. Like as you can see, we are using the WP CLI package and we uploading it, doing the desired task, and then moving it. So then I can go to this. Takes a little bit more, I think, because of the internet connection. Fantastic on this big screen, it's like the Matrix. And now we can move the page. This is our WooCommerce, and now we can activate it. And start working on it. I mentioned something about the UATs with the DKD deploy cucumber package. You can work also with working with cucumber for handling UAT tests. We're using the cucumber gem and mentioned the host. The host could be basically any site. I think I could also test my local written UATs on a Google site or on my production site. So it just runs a basic test for. I'm checking is there title for. Page title, is there some file permission as you can see? I would like to have my composer JSON none that only the system can access it and see it, and a couple of things. And make a test changing anything. Everybody looks fine. Now one of the tests should be red, and with such a scenario I can handle jobs like every page has to have one H1 tag, let's say, and because I can check it. I mean, if there are two H1 tags, then the test will break, and we can monitor a little on our editor, so we can establish basic basic level of our site that we are using all the best practices. So how everything looks like on the server, on every server basically, I will show you here. So this is our document root. We have the current path. The nice thing, this is coming from Capistrano basically, from Capistrano. We have the current path is a symlink to the latest release path. In our release path releases folder, we have a couple of releases. We can define how many releases we want to keep. Currently it's defined five releases. And you can just remove the symlink and change it back. Or you can use also the Capistrano rollback, the wiki deploy rollback command. And that's it. Extending wiki deploy is, as I mentioned, is easy. We wrote basically this add ending as a command. And we are firing the CLI task, and that is it. We are using, it's Ruby code, we are using CLI commands and just firing the create and a rule. And with this scenario, I can also copy the complete line and make a Capistrano task for editor rule of everything that I want. And that's it basically. I mean, this is the structure. If you don't want to use, the problem with Composer is that not every package is inside of the packages repository. You can work also with your own Git repository as package source. But if you don't want to use Composer, you can do it also because wiki-deploy takes everything that is inside of the HE docs, bundles it and deploys it on your stage. That's it. So for plugins in a Composer installation, we have to migrate the plugins, the WP content inside of the core. We have to migrate it in a different folder, so because it's just a Capistrano requirement. So if we need a new plugin, then just download it, extract it, and place it somewhere there, and that's it. And then cap deploy. Yeah. These are the gems, as I mentioned. We have the wiki deploy core. These are the base functionalities. It's not connected to any specific framework. Wiki-deploy PHP brings a Composer integration, Doctrine 2 migration. Doctrine 2 we were using on Type 3 side, so for migrating database content, the clear cache, and a couple of PHP tasks, so we can work with PHP. We have the wiki-cucumber test gem. This wiki-cucumber brings couple of base functionalities and useful step definitions for working with UATs. And here you can also in your local project cucumber file, you can also extend your step definition. So maybe you need a custom step definition. You can do it and run the task. We have our documentation site. There are a couple of infos. Currently, our WordPress package is still in the development. The idea is that we present this workflow, because the workflow is quite optimized for working with Type 3. And last year I mentioned I would like to have it for WordPress, and that's why maybe you will have a couple of problems. But as you can see, it's working, and I will publish in the next month this package here for working WordPress in a custom repository, so you can test and try it. I will publish also a test version, so a test background page, so you can easily install it. Yeah, basically that's it. Questions, thank you, and it would be great if I can get a little bit of feedback about is it good for WordPress developer, or is it just a Type 3 thing and it's not interesting for you?
I saw your config file. You keep the same login information in the environment, so the database, the WordPress config file, or do you have different if statements within the config file?
Yeah, we can define different. I'll show you. This one?
The WordPress.
We have one wp-config file, but we don't put all the credentials over there. I can show you, this is also a really nice thing. We have here our shared folder. Here we can store, let's say, assets or maybe an assets in the configuration file, where you can see there are our DB credentials. And this file we're integrating in wp-config. Basically here we are merging the according to our stage in the depth, so I will take the CapDev takes the dev file, CapIntegration takes the integration file, and I can put all my credentials for the database and everything inside of these two files. And that's it.
How would you approach changes in database when you need to the process? If it's configuration plugin that doesn't work for configuration scope, or adding some test content or something like that?
Test content we can add it. This is a great problem. I mean, also in Type 3 world, we can work with default content, and basically we in our team we're working with something like a golden master. So this is our test content. Currently in this package, there is no possibility to make a special DB migration, but we can download the database from your local environment, commit it to Git, or not, and upload it to your integration with a couple of tasks. That's already possible.
It is already there.
Yeah, it's already, but this is coming from as I mentioned, this is a Capistrano task. And you can see it here. You have here default content, you can separate the content and the structure, and just run cap integration or cap production at default content and takes your content from your repository and draws it somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
And the same with assets. Okay,